Hey guys, welcome to WP Beginner and thanks for tuning in. In this video, I'll show you how you can add a contact form pop-up in your WordPress website. Giving your readers a way to contact you without having them leave your site or the page that they're on is actually a great way to get them engaged on your site. And to get this, we're actually going to install two plugins. The first one is OptinMonster, and it's a pop-up plugin that you install and use for your website. The next plugin that you're going to need is a contact form plugin of some sort, and we're actually going to use the WPForms Lite version. But if you have something like Gravity Forms or Contact Form 7, then this will work as well. And just a note that both of these plugins that we're going to use today were actually created by our founder, Syed Balki. So I'm going to go to my dashboard, and you'll want to go over to your plugins area, add new. The first one we'll install is the WPForms Lite plugin. So from here, we'll be searching for WPForms, and this is the one we want. So we'll install that now, and we'll activate it. Great. The next one we want to add, we can add it from here. Look for OptinMonster, and this is the one we want. So we'll install that. And we'll activate it. You will also need to go to OptinMonster's website and choose a professional plan to get this to work. And once we install it, you see it says, let's get connected. So that's why you want to have set up your account with OptinMonster. I already have an account, so I'm going to say, let's get connected. And I need to give it my username and API key. So I'm going to do that real quick. So I'm going to enter the API user key. And the API key. All right, now that I have both of the plugins set up, let's first go in and we'll create our first WP Forms form. So I'm going to go to Add New under WP Forms, and we're going to name it Contact Us. And we're just going to use the simple contact form here. It's in a template that already has most of the fields that I'm going to need. You see right here, we've got the name, email. So I'm going to click Save. Okay. And now that we've done that, I'm going to go back. And this is the one that I want to use. As you can see, I've been playing with it. So I'm going to copy this short code here. And then now we need to go to OptinMonster to create the pop-up. So I'll go to OptinMonster. From the top right, I'll click Create. Opt-in. And this takes me, since I've already logged in, it's taking me to the OptinMonster dashboard, and I can enter the information here. You have to create a title, and they want you to add a website. I'm going to add a new website because this is new. So you'll want to add your site domain there. All right. Now, the design that we're going to use is under Canvas, and Canvas is just like what it's saying. It's like a blank canvas that you can add whatever you want, add whatever HTML, CSS, and short codes or coding that you want. So we're going to use this template, and now we get this blank canvas that we can work with. Over here, you can change it however you want, and you see that the default width and height is here. We'll scroll down, and then here's the custom HTML and CSS that we'll be using. All right, since it is a blank canvas, you're basically going to add all of your custom HTML. And I'm going to use this little bit of code here. You can customize it however you want, but this is on WP Beginner site. We're just going to use that. And you see it, when you're typing something in, it automatically shows up over here and shows you what it looks like. So that's how it looks basically. And you can even customize the CSS. So we're going to grab this CSS. And you notice this div over here. This is specific to each form, so I'm going to show you how you can find that so that you can customize your CSS. But I'm going to just type that in. And to customize our particular CSS, this is the line of code that we want to replace. We want to use this to replace this line of code up here. So I'm going to go in. All right. And now you'll probably see the design later, but for now we'll just keep going through this. So the opt-in cookie duration and the success cookie duration, we want to set that to zero because we want, anytime a reader wants to contact us, we want to give them the option to see this. So otherwise you would keep that at the default of 30 days if you were setting it up for email lists. Finally, we want this to be a manual trigger load. We want it to be based on something that the user does. So we're going to click that. So it'll be a manual trigger, and I'll show you how to set the manual trigger up. All right, now that we have all of this set up, I'm going to click save. And that should be good to go. We're going to close out of that. I'm going to go back to my website. And since I created a new one, I want to refresh the opt-ins. And now you see this one is ready for me to do. By default, it comes over as disabled. So we need to edit the output settings first, and we want to enable it site-wide, and we also want to load it globally, so that means it'll go all over our website. So we want to edit globally, load globally, and then we want to scroll down and we want to parse the content for shortcode. And then the shortcode that we did earlier, that's where we want to paste that here. So we'll need to go back. I happen to have it open in a new tab. So I'm going to copy that here. To find that, you just go under your WP Forms, All Forms, and find the form that we just created earlier. So we put that here, and now it'll handle the shortcode like that. So we can click Save Settings. We can go back to Opt-ins. Now you see that we've done all that. It's now live and ready to be used. So we just need to do one more thing. The final thing we need to do is we need to grab this little bit of code. I'm going to copy that. And then wherever we want this to go. All right, the final thing we need to do is we need to add a bit of code to any and all of the posts that we want this to show up at. So we'll go to posts. You can do this on a page as well. And say I had this really great post here, and I want to encourage them to contact us. So I'm going to go in here, paste all that information there. When you add that bit of code, you want to make sure you're in the text area. So from visual editor, make sure you're in the text editor, and you can just copy that information. And this slug I need to replace with the slug that I had. And then that way, when you look at it, you see that it's a link. So we'll update that, then we'll go to that page to see what it looks like. And now when you click on the Contact Us, you see this great pop-up that encourages people to contact you. If you like this video, click on the like button and go ahead and leave us a comment there. We'd love to hear from you. And subscribe to our YouTube channel to get the latest videos.